morning, people. I hope you're doing well, my de-lovelies, because I've got something delightful for you. And it may contain science. So, what are we talking about today? Yes, exactly. A team of engineers at MIT have been studying a bizarre water-related phenomenon in solar desalination, that being the production of clean water using the power of the sun. With global demand for fresh water, solar desalination is a relatively clean energy means of adding to the potable water supply. And though there are two big families of solar desalination technique, neither of them is super efficient. Indirect solar desalination leverages solar panels to convert the sun's energy to electricity, which then powers the desalination mechanism, the most popular one being reverse osmosis, but there are a couple of others as well. Then, there's direct solar desalination, which uses the sun's thermal energy to distill water. Modern thermal systems have a bunch of fancy on top to try to capture waste energy from the distillation process to maximize efficiency. So it's true that even a lot of indirect techniques are often also thermal at the point of separate fresh water from other stuff. So even if you're powering your desalination plant with electricity, a lot of processes are still sun hot. Boil water. Solar desalination engineering, then, focuses really hard on tuning the various components of these systems to eke out every little bit of energy efficiency they can. In the case of indirect solar desalination, you're trying to improve the solar panels to minimize energy loss when converting from solar to electrical energy, or to invent more efficient thermal mechanisms so less energy is lost in distillation, and so on. All of which is to say that our engineers are highly incentivized to be on the lookout for weird water science to get those energy efficiencies from, and that's probably how they came across this super weird body of literature that's developed over the past couple years, and developed a truly unbelievable explanation. This is hydrogel. Soft contact lenses, also hydrogel. A lot of burn dressings, hydrogel. Disposable diapers absorbency is achieved with a hydrogel. They are a family of versatile super jellos with a lot of applications in biomedical engineering, but also, it turns out, some applications in solar desalination. See, a bunch of researchers have found that water in hydrogel evaporates really quickly at a rate that exceeds the thermal limit. And not like a little bit, like double or even triple the theoretical maximum evaporation rate that could be explained by the amount of thermal energy going into the system. Real quick, does that mean that conservation of energy is broken and it's the end of thermodynamics as we know it? No, absolutely not. What we're looking at is some additional, ostensibly non-thermal source of energy we're not accounting for, which, yes, might be weird, but not breaking the foundational principles of physics weird. But the engineers who discovered this weren't getting deep into the whole what the physics of it all, no. Engineers immediately started building out cool systems that took advantage of these properties of hydrogel. Like, hey, look at this inexpensive, easy to fabricate mechanism that improves the energy efficiency of desalination. And that's probably how it came across the desk of our MIT mechanical engineers, who work on nanoscale heat transfer and energy conversion. Super relevant to solar desalination. But they are a curious lot, and eventually someone was going to ask, how exactly does all this work? Well, this paper in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences doesn't get into all the preliminary studies our researchers performed to try to answer that question, but suffice it to say that the first step in figuring this whole thing out involves a lot of playing with hydrogels and water under a whole bunch of different experimental conditions. After all, where do you even begin to figure out how water is evaporating when all the thermal energy in the system seems to be accounted for? So I have to assume that they were pretty far down the rabbit hole when they got to the answer that they actually published in this article. It was light. That's right. Light. Not the heat from the light. The light itself was accelerating the evaporation rate, which is weird. Because light itself is pretty good at passing through water. You know, being transparent and all that. In fact, our engineers typically put dark-colored particles and dyes into water at solar desalination facilities to facilitate thermal conversion in these desalination projects. So, our researchers first create their own controlled conditions to demonstrate the previous finding, that water and hydrogel evaporates at a rate that exceeds the thermal limit that it should. Then, they measured the mass lost from hydrogel, which measures how much water evaporated, as they exposed the hydrogel to light at different wavelengths, different colors, and monitored the temperature at the hydrogel surface. The evaporation rate changed at different wavelengths and peaked at green in this solar simulator light, which is very much a function of the light, and not the heat, suggesting that this wasn't a purely thermal phenomenon. In fact, all of this happened entirely independently of the heat generated at those various wavelengths. When the researchers subjected the hydrogel to the same thermal inputs in the dark, the hydrogel immediately returned to evaporating normally and never exceeded the thermal limit. That's not 100% proof. Ideally, you'd want to identify a specific mechanism for the light effect and then test that mechanism experimentally, but it's pretty persuasive evidence that this isn't just heat we didn't realize we had. But how come it took hydrogel for us to discover this phenomenon, which our engineers at MIT have termed the photomolecular effect? After all, we have been boiling water thousands of years, and it's not like we were always doing it in the dark. So if this phenomenon is real, why didn't we notice before now? What does hydrogel do differently? Well, our researchers think the phenomenon itself is due to a hypothesized interaction between photons and water. According to theoretical models, water molecules form clusters, connected by continuous paths of hydrogen bonds that form a network. Because photons themselves do have energy, not thermal energy, but energy nonetheless, our engineers propose that photons can cleave these little clusters of water without going through thermal processes. In, say, a bucket of water, what our researchers might call bulk water, there's nowhere for those clusters to go, so the water just stays in the water with the other water. Although neither water itself nor hydrogel absorbs much light, again, transparent. The hydrogel facilitates the water's light absorption, and our researchers believe that this amplifies the photomolecular effect enough that we actually detected it. In other words, the effect was always there. It just took hydrogel to make it prominent enough for us to notice. Well, okay, Sam. You're saying that hydrogel amplifies the effect. Doesn't that mean that the effect is happening on a smaller scale anywhere that photonically cleaved water clusters could evaporate and escape? Actually, yes, that is the implication of this research. In the bulk of bulk water, like an ocean, yes, water clusters have nowhere to go. But just as water evaporates off the surface of a hydrogel, the same thing can happen at the surface of bulk water, like the ocean. Or in water droplets of fog or clouds, anywhere the sun touches, Simba, and where the water clusters actually have room to evaporate off. But wouldn't that mean this photomolecular effect's been happening all over the world this whole time? Yes. And our researchers already have a grant to study this proposed photomolecular effect in the context of climate change modeling. That said, engineers are still engineers, and this particular group of them is still profoundly interested in the original mission that brought them to this discovery in the first place, solar desalination. The group hopes that this discovery will lead to those improvements in efficiency that we talked about at the beginning of this segment, and by implication, make desalination a cheaper and more viable technology to supply water to people around the world. First, though, they're going to have to stare down the barrel of some very skeptical scientists. Like, almost we found faster-than-light neutrinos. Level of skeptical. Our researchers are collaborating extensively to replicate their findings robustly and to conduct more focused hypothesis-driven explorations of this alleged photomolecular effect. Whatever those studies yield, I promise, I won't make light of their results.